all my students. The Evolution of Computers Part 2. Students, you have learned in the Part 1. That means 5 calculating devices. Last lecture, student, we have learned what is a computer. Computer is derived from the word compute, which means to calculate. And we have learned 5 calculating devices, that is early calculating devices, that is history of computer. First one, abacus, Napier bones, Pascal adding machine, jacquard loom, analytical and difference engines of Charles Babbage. So now we are going to learn the lady who is the first lady programmer, that Lady Ada Lovelace and Horlitt machine. Mark 1, ENIAC and the generation of computers. Let's revise. This is abacus. Abacus is a manual device. It's developed in China. It was developed in China. It was made up of wooden frame consisting of rods, each having bits in them. The frame was divided into two parts, heaven and earth. Each rod in heavens had 2 bits and each rod in earth had 5 bits. It was used for addition, subtraction and multiplication and division. The abacus still used as a calculating device in many countries like Japan, Russia. One can do very big calculation very quick. Use an abacus. Napier's bones. Sir John Napier invented this device in 1617. It was used for simple calculations like addition, subtraction, multiplications, and division. This device had a set of rods and or bones with multiplication tables inscribed on them. Pascal adding machine. Sir Blaise Pascal, a French mathematician, invented an adding machine called Pascal's calculator or Pascaline at the age of 19 in year 1642. It used gears, wheels and dials. Numbers were displayed by rotating the wheel. It was capable of performing addition and subtraction. The gears principle was further employed in many mechanical calculators. Nowadays, a taximeter is perfect example of a mechanical calculator. Jacquard's loom, punch card. In 1804, French weaver named Joseph Marie Jacquard invented a way of automatically controlling the threads on a silk loom. It had a long row of wooden cards with a series of holes punched into it, a pattern. The loom could automatically read the designs from the cards and weave accordingly. This loom was known as Jacquard's loom. Analytical and difference engines. Charles Babbage, a British mathematician, is considered as a father of computer. He invented working model of a mechanical computer called the difference engine in 1822 and analytical engine in 1833. The analytical engine had 5 units: input, output, store, mill and control. These units work like the modern computer. All the computers which are used nowadays are based on it. Stores was for storing the data. Mill was the calculating unit. Control unit was used for supervising all the units. Charles Babbage and his analytical engine in 1833. Lady Ada Lovelace is known as the first lady programmer. In computer history, she was the first introduced the concept of programming, that is, how a machine could be made to follow a series of instruction. And she introduced the concept of binary, arithmetic, and feed the instruction into the analytical engine. Hoerlith machine. In 1889, Hermann Hoerlith developed an electronic machine. It is used for calculate and also record the data. The data, that is, read the numbers as well as letters. It's called tabulating machine as well as census machine also. The input was given through the punch card. The punch cards were used to record and store the data or information. Students have learned some fact. Jacquard loom was the first machine that used the interchangeable punch cards to obtain the design pattern on the clothes automatically. Later, these punch cards were adopted by British mathematician Charles Babbage as an input-output medium for his process, analytical engine, and an American statistician, Hermann Hoerlith, to feed the data to his census machine. Charles Babbage also gave an idea of a mechanical digital computer. It's called the analytical engine. ABC, long form, Antonsoff Berry computer. Antonsoff Berry computer was the first digital electronic computer built by John V. Antonsoff and Clifford Berry during 1937-1942. In this machine too, punch cards were used to control its operations. Howard Mark I is considered to be the real beginning of the era of the modern computer. Mark I. Howard Aiken, the man was developed the first computer that ran on electricity. It was known as Mark I. It is developed in 1944. This was a general purpose computer which was as big as hall, 8 feet height and 15 feet long, 1800 kg weight. So students, you can see in the picture, it is capture more place. ENIAC. ENIAC stand for electronic, numerical, integrator and calculator. This is developed by Mr. John Macaulay and John Prosper Eckert in 1945. The machine captured the area 680 meters, 28,000 kg weight. It consists 18,000 vacuum tube and 1,000 times faster than Mark I. So ENIAC, cost of millions of dollars, occupied a whole room and could be do 100 calculation in a second. The present computer look, it's a gradually from the early computer. So it could add two large number in 200 microseconds. The first general purpose electronic digital computer was invented by John Macaulay and John Prosper Acker in 1945. UNIVAC. UNIVAC stands for Universal Automatic Computer. In 1951, it was the first commercial electronic computer designed by Prosper Acker and John Macaulay. It was the first computer to handle the both numerical and text data, equipped with magnetic tape unit and use the buffer memory. You can see in the picture, students, magnetic tape in a circular shape. It is generations of computers. Based on technology used in computers, the development of computers can be divided into various generations. First generation computers, 1940 to 1956. In this generation, computers were used vacuum tubes and magnetic drums. Computers of first generation were very large and expensive. They consumed a great deal of electricity and generated a lot of heat. These computers were not able to solve more than one task at a time. These computers relied on machine language to perform any operation and could solve only one problem at a time. You can see machine language perform like a 0 and 1, that is binary language. Input was based on punch cards and paper tape. Output was displayed on printouts. These computers were slow and expensive and large in size, consume a large amount of energy. Energy means electricity. So that create more heat. For example, UNIVAC and ENIAC. Second generation computers, 1956 to 1963. The second generation computer replaced vacuum tubes and use transistor. You can see in the picture transistor. And second generation computers move from machine language to assembly language, which will allow the programmers to specify instruction in the words. Punch cards and paper tapes were used as an input device, and output was presented through the printouts. These computers were faster, cheaper, smaller, and more efficient than the computers of first generation. Examples: IBM 1400, IBM 350. Third generation computers. Third generation start from 1964 to 1971. In these generations, computers were used integrated circuits in the technology, and magnetic disks were used for the storage. These computers were small in size and used storage capacity, higher calculating speed and reliability than the previous generation of computers. Keyboard was used as an input device, and monitors and printers were used as output devices. For example, IBM 360 and Apple I. Fourth generation computers started 1972 till present. The fourth generation computers, that is the present day computers, are based on very large scale integrated circuit called microprocessor. You can see in the picture, microprocessor is a small chip that consists of a number of integrated circuit in it. High capacity magnetic disks are used to store the data. Input is done through the keyboard, mouse, scanner. Besides monitor and printer, various new devices such as plotters and speaker have evolved as output devices. These computers can be linked together to share storage capacity, space and data. These computers are portable, reliable and cheapest among all the other generations. Example, personal computers and IBM. Fifth generation computers, it is underdeveloped, now presents and beyonds. These computers are still in development. Through there are some applications such as the voice recognition that are being used today. The goal of the fifth generation computing is to develop devices that respond to natural language input and to imitate human reasoning. These computers are generally referred to a supercomputer, which is may be very useful. They will use artificial intelligence. They will be able to think, decide and act like human beings on their own. A supercomputer may further increase the speed amazingly. Artificial intelligence. Nowadays we are using mobile, laptop, so some softwares are needed. So many of companies has made artificial intelligence software. First one, Cortana, is described by Microsoft, its creator, as a digital assistant. It uses a Bing search engine to produce information, answer to users, and also offers reminders. Notebook features and calendar options. Cortana ships with the various software operating system for computers and other devices, including Windows 10 Mobile. Google is the fastest search engine in digital life. In India's fastest growing digital marketing and website developed company, Amazon, like many companies, investing heavily in artificial intelligence. Apple Series. Siri is a personal assistant integrated within the Apple device operating system. Apple Siri is a virtual assistant. It's a part of Apple, included like iOS, iPad, iPhone, iPod Touch, macOS. Students, now recap. What we have learned, that we will see in short. Charles Babbage is considered as the father of computers. He invented the difference engine and analytical engine in 1833. ENIAC was the first general purpose electronic digital computer invented in 1946. UNIVAC-1 was the first computer to handle the both numeric and text data. Lady Augusta Ada Lovelace is considered as the first programmer who suggests the binary data storage. The first generation computer were based on the vacuum tubes. The second generation computer were use transistor in the place of vacuum tubes. Third generation computers were based on integrated circuits. Fourth generation computers are based on microprocessor. Fifth generation computers involve artificial intelligence, where computers can behave, think and react in the same way as humans do. Question number A, multiple choice question. Put tick to the correct one options. First one, who among these invented Napier bones? Option A, Sir John Napier. Option B, Blaise Pascal. C, Charles Babbage. D, Hermann Hörlitz. So answer is that Sir John Napier. Which one this was invented by Charles Babbage? So answer is different engine. Third one, computer dash computer was used for calculation till 1959. Mark 1. Lady Ada Lovelace was the first dash. She is the first lady programmer. Write true or false. Mark 1 was a very big in size. Answer is true. From 1945 to 1979, computers were invented for different purposes. That is also true. ENIAC was a large machine with about 18,000 vacuum tubes. True. Fourth one, International Business Machines means IBM developed the first electromechanical digital computer called Mark 1. This is also true. Students, you have to mark in your textbook which one term you have learned. Find the names of device and the terms. We have learned generation of computers. In short, we will revise in which years and what characteristic. First generation 1944 to 1959. Use vacuum tubes. Second generation 1959 to 64. Use transistor. Third generation computer 1964 to 75. Use integrated circuits. Fourth generation 1975 till present. Use microprocessor. And fifth generation under development and it will be artificial intelligence. Students, we have learned many calculating devices in a different years. 5000 years ago, abacus. 1670, Napier bones. 1642, Pascaline. 1833, difference engine. 1837, analytical engine. And Mark 1, 1930. Thank you, students. I hope you have learned the evolution of computers and generation of computers.